Yes. Good morning, Julia. Ano, salamat po sa lahat ng mga nanonood sa VAD Trip page and sa ating mga watch parties across different groups, DBA, Philvan, Freelancing Philippines. Ano, ang dami-dami na pong ano, nag-a-allow na mag-watch party and sa mga lahat na nanonood sa aming mga profile. Hi, guys!
Trip show para mapanood nyo kami and mapanood ninyo yung mga past videos namin. Meron din kaming YouTube channel, nasa LinkedIn din kami, at sinisimulan na rin po namin i-convert yung mga videos namin into podcast.
So, kung gusto nyo kaming, kung gusto nyo marinig ang kulitan namin, kahit walang video, yung tawa na...
Yung aming tawa. Yes, I know you're still missing my kitty ears. Medyo mainit pa ngayon. So, naka-ano muna siya, naka-bakasyon.
Ah, opo. So, ba't kita binupo?
Hoy, hindi naman ako ganun katanda.
may explanation naman dyan, mga ka-VA. Kasi ang guest natin ngayon ay ang aming, parang mother hen yun namin to ni Vida. Kaya naka-pomo na ako ngayon. So, correct. She is the director for ICT industry in the ITC Industry Development Bureau, DICT. Nakukwento, so naririnig yun in the past episodes, madalas kami magkwento ni Vida about DICT and its programs. So, now yes. You will hear it straight from DICT. So, please welcome our guest. Palakpak po kayo habang nandiyan kayo nanonood sa amin, si Director Emmy Lou Delfin.
Yay!
Hello.
Hello. So, Ms. Emmy Lou Delfin is from the Department of Information, Communications, and Technology. ICT. So that is the wave of the future. So Ma'am Emmy, ano po ang DICT? Ano po yung mandate niya?
Okay, but first of all, good morning sa lahat. Thanks Vida and Julia for inviting me here, and we're actually happy so that we can, share the programs of DICT, particularly capacitating the Filipino. So, DICT, we were created in 2015. We're celebrating our fourth year this coming June, because we were created in June 2015. So, DICT, we're actually the primary policy planning, coordinating, implementing administrative entity of the executive branch of the government, which actually handles the information and communications technology, or ICT. So, we have actually several mandates. So, for example, we have actually, in terms of ICT policy and planning, improvement of public access. We're talking about infrastructure. So, we have resource sharing and capacity building, cybersecurity policy and program coordination, and consumer protection, and ICT industry development and countryside development. So those two actually mandates are actually part of the bureau that I'm handling, which is ICT Industry Development Bureau. So so we have six actually mandates under DICT, and our group is task number one to help actually improve for the IT BPM industry, IT BPM, which includes call center, software development, animation, game development. So we want to maintain our global competitiveness. Mm-hmm. And also, we also support digital startups and, of course, online freelancing industry and e-commerce. So those four actually sectors are part of the ICT industry.
And as far as I know from mm-hmm. industry reports, mm-hmm. we're kind of like on the top.
Yeah, since 2018, we're number one in terms of the voice-based services. And you know why, diba? There's no country in the world aside from us, magaling talaga mag-English. Pagdating sa, we're very warm people, accommodating. So, other countries don't have those kinds of qualities. Yeah. However, yun nga, but the presence of AI and robotics, we have upskill, reskill our people. And we have several programs for that naman.
Oh, that's nice. Kasi I think that's the next wave.
Mm-mm-mm.
In a sense, AI, data science, mm-hmm. and a lot of upskilling.
Yeah, actually right now, no, we have in the BPO industry, we're not talking about the online freelancing industry. Yeah. So under the BPO industry, or IT BPM, we have 1.2 million jobs in the country as mm-hmm. of end of 2018. And mm-hmm. Out of 1.2, 300,000 jobs are actually working outside of Metro Manila. So those cities we used to call them next wave cities. We now digital cities. What are those cities like? Of course, Cebu, Davao. In Mindanao, we have Cagayan de Oro. We have Zamboanga City. In Visayas, we have Bacolod, Iloilo, Dumaguete. Yeah, and sa Luzon naman, we have Lawag, Baguio, Dagupan, of course, Metro Clark. So, those we have 20 plus cities that have fully BPO talents or locators already. So, the goal of the ICT in partnership actually with the private sector, particularly there's an umbrella association called IBPAP, that's the... of all the BPO companies in the Philippines. So the goal is for us to be able to achieve 1.8 million jobs. And please note that 500,000 of these jobs should be coming from outside of Metro Manila. So meaning right now, if there are 300,000 jobs, we need 200,000 jobs that should actually be coming from outside of Metro Manila. So that's the goal of DICT in partnership with the other government agencies and private sector partners.
Okay, so ma'am, ngayon na alam na natin yung mandate ng DICT. What programs can the public expect this coming year from the DICT?
Well, under the ICT, because I'd like to focus on the programs particularly under the ICT industry development and some of course countryside development. We have actually an umbrella initiative called Digital PH. Digital PH used to have 4 programs, but basically the goal is to be able to help to actually bring ICT opportunities to all Filipinos, especially for those people in the countryside. So that's the goal of Digital PH. So capacitating Filipinos either through online freelancing, either in the BPM industry, or either for them to become digital startups or technopreneurs. So we have 6 programs. In fact, we are just going to launch this program in June. So we have 6 programs. One is the Digital Cities PH. As you know, again, I mentioned that one of the 6 mandates of the ICT is countryside development. Mm-hmm. So we want to bring the jobs, the opportunities outside of Metro Manila in the countryside. So under the program called Digital Cities PH, we actually capacitate cities or locations outside of Metro Manila for them to become viable locations. Mm-hmm. Basically, decongesting Metro Manila. Mm-hmm. And as you know naman that diba, every year we graduate around 350,000 people. Ang ironic mm-hmm. lang doon is until now, 75% of those graduates are actually working in Metro Manila. Yet, 75% nga outside of Metro Manila yung graduate. So the goal is at least sana ma-balance yung yung jobs opportunities for the people, for the Filipinos. So digital cities nga, so we work together with the local government, call it ICT Council. So there are some ICT councils. So the ICT Council is actually a multi-stakeholder organization composed of the academe, private sector, the local government units, mm-hmm. And other sectors that actually should be able to help drive the ICT ecosystem in a particular location. So, ang ginagawa namin, we help that council, first of all, establish one. Kasi mm-hmm. ang rule nila is, dapat sila ang mag-champion ng location nila to be able to promote ICT in terms of job creation, in terms of bringing locators and providing capacity building or mga skills development for their people. So that's part of the Digital Cities Page program. And In fact, for the past years, no, we've been ranking cities according to criteria. Kasi for a city to become a digital city, there are actually criteria. First, very important is, ang tinatanong kasi ng locators, how many graduates do you have? Do you have schools, colleges, universities? Do you have mga test the schools and do they have graduates? So basically talent, availability of talent. So second criterion is availability of infrastructure. We're talking about telecoms infrastructure, even yung condition of roads, there are buildings ba available for them, and pati yung mga, if there are available flights or meron bang domestic or international flights. And then, so yung second, no, infrastructure. And then the third one is cost. Cost of doing business. So, kino-compare yung cost ng ano, different cities in terms of yun, utilities, power, kasama lahat yun. And then the fourth one is business environment and risk management. So, kasama dun yung safety, security, navigation, pati yung disturbances to natural calamities. So, kasama dun. So, yun yung criteria para maging city, ang maging digital city ang isang city. So, we actually continue every year to help develop cities. Right now, there are 20, at least 30 digital cities that we call. I can actually provide you the list. But so, the goal is dapat nga, if we can bring more BPO locators, which means more jobs to those cities nga outside of Metro Manila. So that's one. That's the Digital Cities Page program. The second one is stepping up the value chain, or we call it Digital Services, which is the new name. It's basically, diba, I told you that we're B number one in the world in terms of voice-based services. But the goal is, under the stepping up the value chain, is for us to step up. So meaning, we also want to be a global leader in non-voice services. So kasama dito yung software development, yung finance and accounting, health information management, including game development and animation. So we work closely with different ICT kasi each sector merong kanya-kanyang association. So we always work with them. We always ask them, how can the government help you actually be able to step up yung kanya-kanyang sector. So under the Digital Services or Stepping Up the Value Chain program, we have several trainings. So kasama dun yung, we have Lean Six Sigma for IT BPM training. So we have business analytics training. We have coding bootcamp or software development training, and ano pa ba? Medical coding training. So those are the different trainings that we provide together with the industry. And aside from the trainings, we also have, we also support yung participation to international conferences wherein DICT actually provides a country pavilion wherein we bring Filipino companies, depending sa country, like if we go to France to promote the creative or animation and game industry. So we go to, like, currently there is an ongoing software development exposition in Japan, wherein my assistant director is actually there participating, heading the Philippine delegation, composed of Philippine software companies. So meaning they can bring more Japanese investors to the Philippines for them to locate, no? And we also have, a few months ago, we went to the U.S. We also brought Filipino health information management companies to also promote our health information management, kasi number one pa rin natin ang US in terms of market for the health information management services. So naka-line up lahat yun. Like this coming June, we also have a Philippine delegation to Connecting Asia. To also promote niya to the ASEAN, to the Asian market. And so, actually, siguro sana yung 1 hour, no, if I can, but so second pa lang yun, second program pa lang. But every time, you know, we plan, we implement, we always consult, we always plan together and implement together with our industry partners. Okay, so the third one, hiniwalay namin yung yung animation and game, and so we call it digital creatives because we also want to, you know, have a global branding, a Filipino brand, kasi maraming mga, you know, we have a lot of great animators, Philippine animators. In fact, they're working sa Disney, Pixar, but they can they cannot say that, hey, this is a Filipino brand, because ina-outsource nga ng American and other foreign animation companies. So the goal of the digital creatives is that for us to have our own local content, and we can proudly say that, hey, this one is a Filipino brand. So that's the digital creatives. Pang-third na yon. The fourth one is digital startup, or this we used to call it seed PH program. The seed PH or digital startup program naman, the goal is for Filipinos to also look into the you know, opportunities to become entrepreneurs or digital startups. Kasi diba tayo, we have been programmed by our parents that after
maging employees,
maging employees times, diba? So the goal of digital startup program is for us to create, you know, Filipino startups.
Yes, we can have our own
business. Yes, diba? Kung si, ano nga, si Malaysia, it's, diba, Grab Taxi, Uber, Germany, diba? So, of course, US brands like Facebook, Google. So, we all to have our own Filipino global startup brand. And that's the goal of digital CP, digital startup program. But gusto ko lang emphasize, under this program, marami din siyang projects, but what I want to actually emphasize is we have an annual pitching competition for college students.
Kasi, I saw some content about that there.
Call it PSC, or Philippine Startup Challenge. PSC. In fact, we are going to start our PSC for high school students. This is our fifth.
Nice.
Oo, katatapos lang namin ng fifth run for college students. And grabe, amazing, magagaling talaga yung mga college students. Even mas marami, lalo na yung mga people from the countryside like Baguio, Iligan, Davao.
Yeah. I think Baguio yung nanalo.
Yeah.
Yeah, yes.
So, yun, because based on our consultation with the startup community, again, every time we plan, we also consult the startup community. We're talking of partners like Idea Space, diba? Sila Launch Garage, PSIA, kasama yun sa mga partners namin. So ang sinasabi na kulang pa rin actually yung mga great ideas. So how can we start that? Dapat mag-change muna yung mindset ng Filipinos as early as, you know, high school and college na, hey, as long as you dream big, as long as you have your crazy idea, as long as, you know, your idea will somehow create a positive impact or it will change the world, then hindi kailangan mo ng capital, just need, di ba, that crazy idea na that can help social problems. So that's the fourth program. The fifth one is ihuli ko na yung the focus now is, di ba, online freelancing. The fifth one is digital MSMEs. This is our newest program. Kasi we're also mandated to help MSMEs become globally competitive through ICT. Of course, in partnership with DTI and the private sector. So here, the goal is, you know that si Ms. Janet, ang ano nito ha, kinu-quote ko, sabi niya, that's according to the e-commerce roadmap. There are actually 1 million MSMEs in the country. Around, actually less than 100,000 or 50,000 have online presence. So ganon ang challenge. So how can we promote our Filipino MSMEs if wala silang global presence or wala silang website? Which actually, di ba, yung ano natin sa Rural Impact Sourcing is we pair yung ating scholar with the MSME, but it's actually the scholars that do the ano the websites. But for this digital MSMEs program, MSMEs program is diretso ang training to the MSMEs themselves. Instead of having scholars, you know, do their social media. or websites. We are going to have a pilot for this year kasi bago to, together with our partner DTI Export Management Bureau with the Philippine Exporters Confederation of the Philippines. Kasi there are still exporters, Filipino exporters that don't have really online presence.
Oh, yes. I have a friend who exports handicrafts and furniture. Mm-hmm. Wala siyang website. I've been telling him for the past decade. One decade na 10 years na, uy, ba't wala kang website?
Dapat nag-ano ka na, Spida? Nag-volunteer ka na ng... Or no, I mean, could have paired that one to our scholar.
That's true. That's true.
And I agree, ang laking impact ng online presence. Kasi parang isang success story nga namin dito sa Davao, mm-hmm. yung Mang Danny's Ice Cream. As in, mm-hmm. ano lang siya, parang dirty ice cream vendor. Tapos, mm-hmm. ano, yung napansin niya, ay, napapansin ako on social media, so naging active siya on Facebook. May ano siya? Ngayon nag-ano na siya, meron na siyang booth sa iba't ibang places, nag-ano he takes orders, so, active niya sa Instagram, ang active niya on Facebook, yeah. And he doesn't even have a website yet. So parang pinipilahan si Mang Danny dito.
Actually, there's another one, ano din, success story in Bogo. Dirty ice cream din. So, pinair natin sa scholar, yung MSME, who's actually also very active sa ICT Council there. In fact, I'm not sure if he's the president. Uh-huh. So, alam niyo ba ngayon, out of the sales, kasi after, di ba, yung 21-day campaign, he was able to generate grabe sales. And then, dahil dun sa nangyari, nagtayo siya ng kanyang magandang ice cream house.
Oh,
and there's the launch. So, ang sarap ng ice cream niya. So, kung kasi actually he's working in an LGU, ngayon mas malaki pa yung kita ng ice cream niya sa kanyang sweldo as ano ano to working sa LGU. Grabe.
Bakit ang lakas ng ice cream? Kasi ang nalaman ko din is sa Damulturan. Ano? Ang malakas naman, actually product din po siya ng RISTT. Ang specialty naman niya is more grown-up ice cream. So, ano, okay. Tanduay ice cream. Pero,
Tanduay.
Ice cream pa rin. Oo. Masarap. Nakatikim na.
Masarap talaga yung ice cream kahit hindi summer.
Oo. Oh.
Okay. So anyway, I have to last na lang. So this is the next program. Ito yung so we call it Rural Impact Sourcing Program, and I think that's the reason why you invited me here because of that. But diba, I'm not sure if you know already that we are going to rebrand the program from Rural Impact Sourcing to Digital Jobs PH. And we are going to launch this coming June also. Kasi ang laging ano, pag RIS, sabi, we always have to explain pa, ano ba yung rural impact sourcing? At saka, yun nga, but basically it's about digital jobs, diba? It's about online freelancing industry. And rural kasi, medyo inclusive siya, exclusive siya for rural. But in fact, there are actually online freelancers outside of rural, meaning, diba, cities.
Yes.
So, kaya yung ibang mga cities ngayon, in our RIS technical training project, sabi nila, bakit are rural? We're a city.
Kami rin. Sama nyo kami.
So anyway, para lang to be inclusive, whether you're in a rural, in a city, or in an urban, we're calling it now Digital Jobs PH.
Ma'am Emmy, okay lang ba while you're talking, i-flash namin yung mga slides that you prepared?
Because we're actually promoting. Gusto niyo ikwento or may time pa ba? Ikwento yung...
Mamabang pa oras natin.
Okay, oras natin.
Paano
nag-start yung Rural Impact Sourcing Program and basically, why are we doing it? Kasi, di ba kanina I mentioned that we have Digital Cities PH and there are 30 plus cities that are called Digital Cities, but, and then there are criteria. However, we realized kasi that there are locations that are not actually cities. And there are great talents out there na hindi pupunta yung locator because of the certain requirements nga. But the talents in those provinces, municipalities, don't want actually to leave their locations because they just want to work there. Ayaw nila pumunta sa urban cities.
Yeah.
So that's when we actually conceptualize the Rural Impact Sourcing Program.
I recall a story, a news story about this town in...
Kapatagas.
Yes, Mindanao. Sa Lanao ata yun?
Ilanao del Norte.
Eh, yun. IT town na to sa sila.
Some of your viewers right now, ba sila Butuan, si Rachel, I'm not sure if she's actually listening right now. Nakita ko, hindi ko pa siya nire-reply. Tinag niya ako. yeah, so I'm not sure if she's watching. But sila, they're from Kapatagan, Butuan, Lanao del Norte area.
Oh, di ba? Ang layo niyan sa layo sa city niyan. Well, Butuan, malapit. But it's not considered a major city. So, ang layo niyo doon. But they're making it work. I think half the town is already digital in a sense.
Oh. Yeah, oh. We started this program sometime in 2015 when actually si Elance before used, yeah. Diba, Upwork now used to be Elance, mm-hmm. the country manager. Although he's up there already. He actually approached we were not yet DICT then. Ano pa ba kami? Commission on ICT pa yata? Not even ICT o under DOST. Sabi ng taga-Elance, and then eventually, dalawa sila, freelancer.com. So those two biggest platform companies in the world approached us and said na, can we work together because we know that your agency is also providing opportunities through ICT and online freelancing can actually be one of the sources or for employment for opportunities. So before isa lang yung program namin in 2015 that was only the Next Wave Cities. So ginawa namin as a side parang kasi we went to different cities before promoting the BPO industry kasi meron pa ring negative impact until now, negative perception about the BPO industry that is just so we went to the different cities na which is not, diba? Hindi naman ganun yung BPO industry.
Ay, hindi ko alam nyo lang.
So we were really heavily promoting then, and then yun nga when si Elance and Upper to freelancer approached us and said maybe we can also promote the online freelancing industry, particularly in those cities or locations that cannot become BPO hubs. Mm-hmm. So we started a side program. So the whole day before was talks about BPO, the different sectors, and then side activity lang yung rural impact sourcing of the online freelancing. But we were just so surprised, actually amazed, na grabe yung traction. Na parang they realized na oo nga naman pala, there are opportunities for online freelancing, but hindi na kailangan pumunta ng cities to actually work or even go abroad to work because they can actually earn dollars even when they're home, even when they're in barangays or municipalities. So when we saw that there was really a traction about the online freelancing opportunities, then we started having a separate parang roadshow, or we call it RIS workshop in 2016 as a whole day activity. So there we created a whole day workshop wherein kasama nga either si Upwork ang kasama namin or si freelancer, hindi sila nagsasama together. There are actually 10 cities, or Elance or Upwork, can you choose 5? Or freelancer naman, you choose 5, and then we go together, we help promote. But basically, ang ano lang dun is, we tell the opportunities in online freelancing industry at the time, what are the top 10 in demand jobs, how can they actually become online freelancers, ano yung platform that they can apply, and how to become effective freelancers, kasama yun sa ginagawa nyo. For one day lang, a workshop. So, ganun nag-start. And then, after our second year, in fact, yung sa ano, yung sa Kapatagan, doon din nag-start yon because we brought We brought at the time, I'm not sure if Apo is actually listening right now. One of the who used to be counselors approached us and asked, "Can you bring that RIS workshop to Kapatagan, Lano del Norte?" So we brought. In fact, dati meron pang funny nga because some of our speakers, maalala ko si Genesis, si Jen. Then si freelancer si Evan Tan, who used to be the country director or ano ng freelancer. So they were actually having second thoughts of going because of ano nga, they thought that Lanao del Norte is not safe. No. But eventually, so natuloy, and then they realized na Lanao del Norte or Kapatagan is a very nice, peaceful place. So doon nag-start yung aming ano, advocacy sa RIS workshop in Kapatagan. And in that, in 2015-2016 ba, parang mga BPO ano doon, mga workers, na they realized na, oo nga naman, they can actually set up their own company without being employed, they can go back to Kapatagan and then have their own rural BPO.
Oo.
So, yun yung, so nung time na yun, si Bloomberg, yun yung nakita yung viral na video, di ba?
Yes.
Si Bloomberg, si TV5, ask us if they can go to, ano, ask our permission, if they can actually feature Kapatagan, yung story nga doon ni, dati si ano, di ba, si Nilin, na ang ano na, former, ano to, BPO worker, farmer by day, but BPO worker by night. So, Bert went there to feature nga. Meron din si Randy, siya naman, ano din siya, farmer, piggery naman yung kanyang ano. Tapos sa gabi, ano din siya, freelancer or nagkaroon din yung sarili niyang rural BPO. So, na-feature yun, yung Kapatagan. And then, dahil nag-viral siya, there was one, I don't wanna mention lang yung ano ha, yung senator kasi so there was one senator actually captured that na, and then he said na this is really worth, you know, implementing across the country, yung opportunities nga in the rural areas malaki because hindi siya namimili regardless of, di ba, yung education, kasi out of school youth pwede, pwedeng mga persons with disabilities. So, the opportunities actually are inclusive. Walang pinipili. Regardless
you just
of
have age, to, diba? You just have to have the skill.
Yes, the skills. So,
yes.
So kasi, kaya naman, we've been doing, so for more than, what, 3 years, puro workshops lang ang ginawa namin because we didn't have the budget. Ang budget namin for the online for that program is actually less than 1 million yata or at least mga ganon.
Wow.
Hanggang workshop lang kaya ng budget namin. And but we were just so happy na dahil nga nakita ng Senate and maybe ng Congress na okay yon, that's why they gave us additional budget. And so when we had a bigger budget, that's when we actually conceptualized the Rural Impact Sourcing Technical Training or RISTT. Gusto rin namin i-rebrand din kasi RISTT.
Napag-usapan niya nung December, parang...
Oo, oh, diba? Kahit yung boss namin eh, ayaw niya yung...
Pasok yan sa cheer.
Pero maganda na sa RIS, yes na yes, ano?
Yes.
But
oh.
we have to to rebrand. Meron na sanang ano. But so doon nag-start. So in 2017, so we asked nga yung isang expert. I'm not sure if Miss Janice is watching right now. Miss Janatura. So we asked her help nga to put together a module, you know, that can really capacitate people through online freelancing. And ang condition namin sa kanya, sabi ko, Ms. Janet, we have to make sure that after the training, dapat they can land in a job. Kasi we don't want the usual trainings na it's really just the output, like number of people trained. Because our KPI, our indicator is that number of people employed after the training. So hanggang doon kasi yung mini-measure namin if the program or project is successful by, you know, making sure na somehow nag-change yung lives nila after the training because they have their jobs already. So in 2017 niya, we developed together with our consultant nga a module na comprehensive training. We started, diba, as first, una isang module lang. 10-day face-to-face module. So basically on social, diba, web development, social media marketing, content writing, so yun. And then to make sure because you know naman the program no, but for the audience lang. So ang ginawa nga ng DICT together with our consultant nga, we put together a module like attending face-to-face training, but the training doesn't end after the 10th day ng training. So kasi ang unang tatanong nga sa main trainee or scholar, we call them scholars, how can they actually promote their freelancing job or skills kung wala silang parang portfolio na ipapakita to begin with in the first place, yeah. Diba? So, kaya, dinagdagan nga namin ng 21-day campaign. Mm. So, yung 21-day campaign na yun, so, para din ma-practice nila yung kanilang skills, kaya pinair yung scholar or trainee sa isang MSME that does not have an online presence or website. So, dun sa training na yun, yun nga, from 10 days, ang ginagawa ng scholar is actually to develop a website, social marketing, and sa MSME. And for 21 days, every day, di ba, for three times na ipopromote ng online ng scholar yung kanyang profile, and at the same time, ipromote yung products and services through the website developed by the scholar. And we were actually so amazed with, hindi rin namin in-expect na ganun yung impact niya. Na we were actually surprised na during the 21-day campaign, some of the scholars have actually landed on online jobs. Kasi nga, imagine mo kung three times ka every day, in three social media platform, ipopromote mo yung
services mo. Sarili mo.
So talagang magkakaroon ka ng trabaho. And true enough, mostly ng mga graduates, nagkakaroon ng online jobs. And so dalawa nga actually ang naging impact doon because the MSMEs, imagine dati wala siyang global or online presence. Confined lang yung kanyang products or services in a particular area. Now that nagkaroon siya ng online presence or website, global na yung kanyang presence. So, even the sales na na-generate ng MSMEs, nag-increase din. So, because of that nga, success ng training, kaya after our, so, kailan ba? 2017, last year, from 26 locations, dinagdagan kami at natutuwa kami ulit dahil dinagdagan kami ulit ng budget. Kaya from 26 training locations in 2017, last year, we had around 78 locations. We also separate training then for persons with disabilities. Nagkaroon din kami ng training for women in partnership with ILO International for education, kasi nakita din ng ILO na yes, meron din talaga siyang opportunities for for Filipino. So from kaya last year 76, and again we're again happy. Diba 26 tapos 69 ba? Maris, ilan nga ba?
60
ha? 68 pala.
68 last year. Last year,
we're happy to say that we are going to implement it, to conduct it in 96 locations. Hindi lang 96 kasi meron kaming special training for women again. Dalawang for women again with ILO and with virtual naman for PWs. Dalawa din yun. So,
what is that? Virtual this year.
Yeah, so yeah, total of 100 kasi 96. Wow. Yun yung talagang ano, yung open siya for all, but yung dalawa for PWDs and then dalawa for women. So total 100 trainings. Yes.
Oh, diba? Wow. Oh, yung mga expert na dyan na VAs, hanapin niyo sa mga posts namin ni Nidia. Yes. Oh, oh. May mga link dyan for trainers. Kailangan ng DICT ng tulong ninyo.
We need more trainers.
Oh, yes.
Ano, we will...
Ako, meron yata ako next week.
Ay, ano, ipopost namin siya dito sa aming, ano, sa aming page, and we will make the effort to, ano, to share it. And, mami, okay lang kayo, mami?
So, bukod sa trainers, pero bukod sa trainers, yung mga sinasabi ni Ma'am Emmy na programs, meron din, ano, syempre kailangan, kung may trainers, kailangan ng trainers, syempre trainees. Kailangan namin ng trainees.
Yes.
Oh, yung mga tumitingin dyan sa, ano, tumitingin dyan sa Philvan, sa mga pages namin, we've been sharing yung links to the various clusters, to the various regional offices, yung mga call nila sa mga towns na makikita nyo doon, na naghahanap ng trainer, ano, na trainees, sorry, trainees.
Yes.
Oo. So, kung baguhan kayo, hindi nyo masyadong kabisado pa ang paano maging VA, maging digital marketer, maging content writer, yes, or web developer, ano pa ba yung
graphic
program?
Design.
Graphic so, pwede design. Pang, ano, merit lang yung, ano, kasi from comprehensive, di ba, web development, social training. Now we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We have 7 modules na.
Yes.
So,
yes.
Ito, enumerate ko lang para for, ano, no.
Makinig, people.
So, we have 7 modules. First is yung digital marketing and e-commerce. We have virtual assistant training, content writing. So, we have graphic design, social media marketing and advertising, search engine or SEO, search engine optimization, and search engine marketing, and web development. So those are the different trainings that we will be conducting in 100 locations. And siguro, because we have our 8 clusters, DICT cluster offices all over the country, so sila ang actually nag-implement nung ano na to, different trainings all over there. In fact, we have initially started, but because yun nga, dahil sa election, or what, 90-95% of the trainings will be starting after election na. And we need more trainers.
Yes.
As much as possible, we don't want to bring trainers from Metro Manila.
Yes.
We want to have local trainers kung nasan man yung training. Of course, para makapacitate yan, at pati yung cost din, di ba, from yung government cost na pamamasahayan pa namin yung trainers from Manila,
by
airfare accommodation. Kaya we encourage to have more local trainers.
Yeah. And yeah, ano, ipopost namin right now yung ano, yung information on how to apply as a trainer.
As a trainee.
Oo, meron po kayong pupuntahan na website. It is...
You can fill that out.
Oo.
So kung kayo may mga bahay sa probinsya,
yan,
alam ko karamihan ng mga nakikita ko sa or nami-meet ko sa Philvan, mga taga Metro Manila, but we all highly encourage din yung mga taga ano, taga probinsya. Disclaimer, ako taga ano, yes, I live in Quezon City, pero my dad retired in Pangasinan. Pinakabitan ko rin po yun ng internet. So, whenever I'm there, I can work from there as well. So, yun ang aking base when I have my trainings. So, this coming week, baka makita niyo ako sa ibang location.
Ma'am Emmy, since ano, meron na rin po kasi pumapasok na mga tanong on how can people avail of ano, I think specifically the RISTT kasi yun po yung
digital jobs PH na siya.
Digital jobs PH. Like if they kasi nag-post tayo ng ano, link. So, gusto mag-trainer, you just go to the link. Pero kung gusto nila magkaroon ng digital jobs training, digital VH training in their location, how do they do it?
Okay, first of all, the training is open for all. but we will have to go through assessment. So open meaning persons with disabilities, out of school youth, high school mga graduates, hindi kailangan college graduate, even senior citizens, anybody who's really interested to have an online job can actually apply. So, ang ano lang, we, through our DICT cluster offices, meron kaming schedule, so sila nagsischedule ng, merong ano, interview and exam, but it's basic, ano lang, basic ano lang yun, pati yung siguro, kasi requirement that you have to know how to use a computer.
Yes.
Kailangan tayo Facebook account, yun na yun. But it's really more of yung eagerness ng individual to learn yung tinitingnan namin more than anything else.
Yeah, it's happy really ako yung first batch nung na-train ko, a very, walang attitude problems.
Oo.
And they're eager to learn. So that's a nice trait to have.
Oh. And ano rin, kailangan din kasi gawin tong screening dahil ano, being trainers, ano, masasabi talaga namin ni Vida na you're learning skills. Mm-hmm. And ang hirap kasi na kung wala kayong basic computer literacy papasok, mahirapan mag-catch up sa training kasi parang ang expectation doon is you learn the skill right away. Hindi ka hindi ka dapat turuan paano mag-on ng computer. Ganun. Uh-huh. Dapat alam mo 'yon.
And for that pala, Julia and Vida, if they want to ano, learn about basic digital literacy, DICT also provides digital literacy.
Doon muna kayo.
So, I'd also like to promote yung aming Tech for Ed centers, and there are thousands, 2,000 plus Tech for Ed centers in the different parts of the country. Through our Tech for Ed centers, merong basic digital literacy training. So kung yung iba na hindi pa marunong, they can actually go to the DICT office and then apply. Kasi meron ano naman regular yung ginagawa yung basic literacy training before they can join. Saka sila mag-join sa digital jobs training or RIS technical training. So yun, yun muna siguro.
Ito guys, paunang tawag mo dito, kumbaga hint ng mga abangan ninyo sa aming training, halimbawa sa VA training with virtual assistant training na ginagawa namin ni Julia, the first challenge is for you to have typing speed of 65 words or more. So imagine kung dependent ka mag-type at hindi ka masyadong marunong mag-computer, paano mo magagawa yon in the 1 month that you have for the training and the 21-day challenge?
Oo.
And then what more kung papagawan ka na namin ng memes, ng content, ng ano, so medyo ano, mahirap. Kung wala pa kayong basic digital literacy skills, daan kayo sa Tech for Ed program ng DICT. But of course, we want to see you sa digital jobs. Yeah, yun ang goal.
And ang isang na-appreciate ko rin sa program is that, especially in the areas na I've encountered this, priority kasi is out of school youth and the unemployed.
Yes.
So it doesn't matter whether okay lang na hindi ka college graduate, okay lang kahit na high school ka, siguro konting high school lang, as long as you're computer literate and you're willing, as in ano talaga, willing to learn, dun usually paminsan ang nakikita namin kung sino pa nga ma'am yung hindi college graduate pero gusto talaga magtrabaho.
Marami nga akong if I can share. Merong isang market vendor from, in fact, finiture to sa 100 celebration ng ILO. Merong ginawang training for women. So, isang market vendor siya. Nung nakita, tapos ang nangyari, before she joined, nasunog yung kanyang pwesto sa market. So, sabi niya, shucks, ano yung gagawin niya? So, and she was really hopeless, no? And then, she learned about the program. So, nag-apply siya. So nung nag-apply siya, natuto siya, and then eventually nagkaroon siya ng trabaho. Social media manager.
Ganun.
Oo. So doon sa kita niya, kinita niya, napagawa niya ulit yung kanyang pwesto sa palengke. So, yun, ang ginagawa niya sa morning, kasi wala nga siyang pera pang pa tayo ulit ng kanyang pwesto sa palengke. Ang ginawa niya, dahil nagkaroon na siya ng dollar, nagka-earn siya ng dollars, kasi hindi ko alam US ba yun, Australia yung kanyang ano client. Nag-ipon siya for ilang months at nakapagpaayos siya ng kanyang ano, ng kanyang kanyang pwesto ulit. So ang ginagawa niya ngayon, she's actually a market vendor by day. And then after, kasi sa morning lang naman yung bentahan ng So lunch onwards, ano na siya, social media manager. Actually, influencer pala, sabi niya sa akin.
Wow! I'm
a social media influencer.
Imagine ko siguro yung market stall niya, meron na rin siyang ano, meron siyang Instagram handle, tapos meron siya.
I assume, di ba?
Kina-flatlay na rin niya yung kanyang, ano, yung kanyang mga produkto, tapos kinukuha nila picture, o di ba?
In fact, we are going to invite her as one of the speakers. Can I also promote our third Philippine Impact Sourcing Conference?
Okay. Ipo-post namin. Okay. Sige po, ma'am.
Pero magkailan po yun?
That will be in July, 17, 18. Hold on na.
16, 17 po. Nasa ano nyo? In Clark, Pampanga.
Oo, kasi hold on. 16-17 pala.
Oo.
16-17 in Clark, Pampanga. So it's a gathering of the different stakeholders, players in the online freelancing industry. So this is actually open for all, but we have to register. Hindi pa naman kami nag-aano, but we're expecting mga 600 to 800 participants from all over the country. And so itong market vendor na sinabi ko, we will be inviting her. In fact, we are right now screening kung sino yung, alam mo yun, yung parang best or success story na they can actually share during the conference. So it's a 1.5 days conference, so they can learn about. In fact, we are inviting ILO, the country manager, to talk about the future of work. Kasi this one is actually part of the future of work, right?
Yes,
diba?
Yung
freelance. Mm-hmm. So, yon. There will be talks about that, and then on payment, e-commerce, etc. And then ano pa yung sustainability? How to actually establish or set up a rural BPO? So kasama yun, how to sustain it, or even how to establish a cooperative among the online freelancers that will be part of that.
Oh, I'm interested in that.
So we have a success story also. Ooh. Na out of the graduates, nag-create sila, instead of a registered company, nag-ano sila ng cooperative. In fact, nagkaroon sila ng award as the best cooperative NGO in their province. Yung mga taga Carmona, Cavite. We will also ask him to talk about it, yung kanilang journey.
Ma'am, ano po, meron po tayo, ang dami pong na-inspire sa talk natin ngayon, na ang dami pong mga nag-comments, and ano, meron po tayong mga questions. Oh my gosh, ang dami mga shares. So, si Marge, yung guest natin last week, si Marge Aviso, also an RSVT trainer. She is watching. Si Mr. Linel Emmanuel Neri. Director Emmy, please have us here in Misamis Occidental. Saan cluster po yan?
Misamis Occidental. Hold on, ha. Merlin Maris, meron ba daw Misamis Occidental tayo? Misamis Oriental. We have one to in Misamis Oriental, but we're still actually finalizing the locations. But we can tell our cluster office that covers Misamis Occidental if they can also, kasi kami, as much as possible, we want to cover all the provinces. Pwede nga municipalities and cities, hindi lang provinces. So I'm sure that there will be one for Misamis Occidental. Baka nga meron natapos na. But oh, yeah, definitely. Yeah.
Oh, ma'am, yung isang question din po, we know that digital jobs, PH, RIS, mm-mm, is mostly caters to rural rural hubs. Meron daw din po ba sa mga major cities, like Metro Manila? Just in case, yung mga training program for freelancers?
Okay. The goal kasi is, we see that there are a lot of opportunities na in Metro Manila.
Ayon.
Pero na kasi kaya parang 'di ba ang medyo disadvantaged locations niya, 'di ba?
Yes.
Rural areas. However, titingnan din nga namin na even in Metro Manila, pwede pa rin naman, but we just need, you know, a partner siguro, or at least may demand na if we can have one or two ano trainings here. Actually that's possible naman.
Yeah. Oh.
So meron na kaya interested from Metro Manila.
Guys, kung kayo taga Metro Manila, mga VA newbies, petition ninyo yung ano, i-petition ninyo yung kongresista para may gawin naman sila. O di kaya yung inyong LGU, malay ninyo, DICT can help them create a program.
Ano lang siguro, para lang din for the information of the audience na yung when we conduct the project, the training, lagi to in partnership with the LGUs.
Yes.
So for example, yung mayor or governor or yung, yung ano ng province or city municipality, ang ginagawa namin, laging may taya or may counterpart ang LGU. Either sila yung nag... So kami, we provide everything, no, pati venue and yung internet connection. Ang counterpart naman usually ng LGU should be yung food. For like, for example, face-to-face na 10 days, so sila nagbibigay ng nagpapakain sa mga scholars. So laging may ano, may counterpart. Laging in partnership lagi yung ano programs ng DICT. So yun. Pwede ring academe or ano, hindi lang naman exclusive for LGUs. In fact, meron kaming isang partner na SUC, ang ano namin. Oo, katrabaho when we implemented one training in a particular province. So as long as, yeah, we're actually open for partners.
Can it be, a question lang po, out of curiosity, can it be a private company that has a CSR program?
Yes, sa rural program? Yeah, oo. In fact, we can also explore that.
Kasi kung ayaw ng LGU, ang kukulitin ko yung yung kumpanya.
Meron, like, you know, CSR, si Virtual Lahan, that, ano nila, is a CSR project for persons with disabilities. So, sila yung partner namin for training for PWDs.
Ma'am, meron pa po tayong mga ano na nangungumusta. Si Richelle May Sullivan Agustin.
Richelle, yun yung sinasabi ko kanina. Tinag niya ako. Ito lang na-reply.
Oo.
Hi, Richelle.
Ano po?
I'm not sure she is in Bukidnon ba?
Yes, parang, sa Bukidnon po siya ngayon. At may question din po siya. Can we do it in North Cotabato, especially in Pikit, Kidapawan, Kabaka, North Cotabato po?
Okay. Sandali ah. Magko-call ano lang ako. Call at least, Merlin, nagtatanong dito, meron daw ba sa Kidapawan?
Kidapawan, Pikit, and Kabakan.
Naku, tapos na yung sa Kidapawan.
Ito po, meron din si Jet Gelardino. Nagre-request naman sa Cadiz City.
Cadiz City. Alam ko, Cadiz Maris.
Unofficial guest po natin, si Maris Castro.
Siguro, what we can do is, we'll ask you, Vida and Julia, to help us post or promote. Okay. Kasi, there are some clusters, DICT clusters, have already finalized their locations. So, ang gagawin namin, we'll come up with the list of locations para makita nyo. Imagine there are, I said 100 locations. So, parang, per cluster, i-divide, ilan nga ba? 16? locations per cluster yon. So yun na lang yung gagawin namin. So kung nearest, yung saan yung nearest training location, baka they can ano, they can just go there. In fact, based dun sa aming experiences no sa iba. Ano yung iba nagboard kasi malayo, they really took an effort and well spent money para lang matuto. Nagboard dun sa ano. Meron namang iba na sobrang very generous yung mayor na talagang nag-provide siya kasi medyo malayo yung connectivity challenge to issue. Siya ang nag-house ng mga trainers, ng mga trainees sa scholars. Siya ang nagbayad, pati pamasahe.
Oh, wow.
Diba? Ano? Sana yan nandiyan yung ibang mga LGUs.
Okay. May suggestion po si si Sir Linel. Actually, magandang yung suggestion niya. How about you publish daw a Google form to have a survey para makita kung saan yung demand. That's a good idea.
Probably, think, yes. Uh-oh. Probably for 2020 na. Nakaset up na for the year.
Para makita yung, kasi as much as possible, mas gusto namin yung dapat very eager and interested and really willing to learn rather than kami pa ang, alam mo yun, mag-training kayo. Yeah, that's a good suggestion. Thank you for that. We'll take note of that. Okay. Through our clusters. Kasi si cluster yung mag, ano yan eh, per location kasi.
Oo. And si Genesis Rael, related sa mga training, is may darating po bang software development specialization training?
Yeah, so we have we have a separate training for software development.
This is
not part of the digital jobs, it's part of the digital services program wherein we have a six month software development, we call it software development specialty training, or we call it coding bootcamp. We're in for 6 months, dapat full time yon. We had our first pilot last year in Laguna, in Santa Rosa. We're in open yon for out of senior, dapat senior, nakatapos ng senior high, mga unemployed, underemployed, etc. So ang ginawa namin doon, we're just, again, ang sinasabi nga namin, dapat ang impact lagi namin is the number of trainees or scholars, graduates na nagkaroon ng employment. Kasi we always make sure na dapat yung like software companies, lagi namin ini-involve para after the training, they will be actually absorbed or hired. So even the development of the curriculum was actually done by the industry, by the software development industry, practitioners, partners namin. So we're planning to have one in Cebu.
Ah, okay.
We're planning to have one in Cebu by mga third quarter of this year sa Cebu, because it's in partnership with ILO, International Labor Organization, because they're also funding, supporting that. And we're happy nga nung last year na ginawa namin yung software development or coding bootcamp. Most of them have been hired. Alam mo kung ano yung mga companies? Accenture, IBM.
Wow!
Kasi yung curriculum, yung ano, is really fit doon sa
nila.
Because in the first place nga, ang nag-develop nun are actually industry practitioners.
So basically, if you pass it, talagang magaling ka.
Inawa doon, kasi for example, we'll do it like the one in Laguna. Yung ibang participants came from Luzon, from Visayas and Mindanao. Alam mo, nag-board and lodging doon para lang for the training. I mean, they really risk, no? May isa pa ako ma-remember na dati public servant or government employee who actually resigned kasi gusto mag-shift ng career from government to IT. So yun, ganun. Iba-ibang stories actually yung nakikita, naririnig namin. And it's really heartwarming always.
Ma'am, okay lang, a few more shout-outs. Kasi yung na-mention yung initially about healthcare information,
yes,
meron pong nasayahan, like si Michelle Ann Aquino Dacuton, kasi yay for including healthcare information. Mm-hmm. And shout-out to Mr. Sherwin Amol, who is watching ano, ang list of regions or provinces included daw. Okay lang po ma'am, i-share din po natin siya siguro after the broadcast.
Sure, oo.
And ano, meron
no, ha, yung meron ng mga finalists of locations because the others are still finalizing because they have to, 'di ba, to work with the LGU and right now we cannot work with them because it's still
election. So
karamihan ng trainees, if not most of them, trainings will be done in July after nila mag-oath.
Ayun. And ma'am, quick ano lang daw recap. Ano nga po daw yung mga programs for BPO type entrepreneur business yung na-mention niyo po earlier?
Mm-mm. So, programs now, we have digital services.
Mm-hmm.
Creative. So, yung dati kasi one yon, but again, we said na we want to develop our own local content. Kaya yung animation, game development will be part of the digital creatives. And then yung digital services, we're talking about basically the software development. Although pag di ba, pwede rin siya maging part of digital creatives. But if we talk about outsourcing or services, dun sa digital services. If we talk about creation of local content, that will be part of the digital creatives. So, both of the programs have ano, capacity building or training. So, merong business analytics, again, yung medical coding, kasama dun sa digital services. And partnership again with the, we also ano din, promote din yun to our industry association partners.
Ayun, ma'am, may question din dito from Romeo Tome. Ma'am, pwede ma-include sa project ang partnership training suggested by SUC na sa robotics, senior high level?
Senior high level robotics. Well, right now, we're also looking into, you know, coming up with trainings like robotics, AI, machine learning. We're just waiting for, hopefully, ma-approve yung ano namin request for additional budget because, yeah, we believe now we have to upskill, reskill our people. We have to prepare our people for the fourth IR, di ba? The future of work. At kasama nga dun yung robotics, AI, data science, and we're hoping to have those kinds of trainings in the future. Sana nga next year mag-start na.
Oh, nga, nice. Ayun. So, ayun, Julia, may tanong pa tayo.
Actually, pasensya na po, Ma'am Emmy, ha? Ang dami po ng ano.
Okay na.
Pero I think the cover na po namin yung mga questions, mga nag... ano, ng mga nage-hello na lang, like si June Sotelo, hello.
Hi, yes. Sir June. Oo. Si June, I'll see him later or tomorrow.
Oo. And, ano, ang DICT Sultan ko na taga, hi. And, oo. May ilang viewers tayong naratal na umaga tayo ngayon. Manonood na lang sila, ma'am.
Oo.
Yeah. Pero ma'am, at saka ma'am, pahay na lang po ako sa LC1.
Oh, sige, makakarating. Mamayang gabi, nandun na kami.
Guys, nice.
Vida will have a meetup with the RIS graduates doon.
Uy, nice!
pati yung trainers, in fact, i-invite namin. Wala kang time, go.
Gabi.
Hindi, tomorrow night. Kasi tomorrow night pa naman ang ano, ang meetup.
Baka magulat sila. I will see po. Unfortunately, kailangan ko muna ng kumitang kabuhayan. And I will be in the region. I will be in the area po next week din ulit eh.
Sige. Take na lang doon.
Okay, so hi na lang po sa mga ano, RIS graduates.
Ma'am Emmy, any ano, closing statement? May gusto po ba kayong i-promote? May idadagdag?
Yeah, well, first of all, again, thank you, Vida and Julia, for inviting me here. Actually, we need help in terms of promoting our programs, diba? Parang isa sa challenges ng grupo namin is we have a lot of, you know, I can say good programs, pero minsan kulang yung promotion namin at kulang yung reach. And yun nga, through your ano sana, yung program yun na to, you can help us even have more reach pa. Kasi like yun nga, imagine if we're going to run 100 training locations for this year, minsan ang challenge is, dahil hindi ganun napopromote masyado, kulang din yung applicants, both pati trainers and trainees. But definitely, if they learn about this, alam nila na it's really for them. And there are a lot of opportunities out there for them. And again, as long as yun nga, magsipag lang sila, diba? Sure. The willingness to learn. So yun.
Happy to help po. Very happy to help.
Yeah, thank you. Oo. In fact, if there's time, baka yung ibang programs din ma-promote namin or baka magpatulong kami dun sa yung other, di ba, programs like yung ITBPM, like mga training.
Oh, yes.
Okay. In fact, meron kaming irarun nga sa Cebu. We need your help pala kasi, you know what, the condition for ILO, because they're fully supporting women to incapacitate women all over the world, is yung coding bootcamp na yon that I mentioned will be for actually for 50 women.
Nice!
We really had a challenge kasi dapat 40 women, only 10 women actually made it and doon. Kaya 30 men pa rin ang ano. But ideally nga, the goal is of in partnership with ILO, supporting women, capacitate women, is women yung ano. So yun.
Saan po yung kwan? Saan po yung kanilang kuning
sa
boss
Cebu.
Niya? Sa Cebu. So, calling yung mga malapit sa Cebu. Mm-hmm. Oh, 50 women. 50. Mm-hmm. And this is for free pa, no?
Yeah, this is a scholarship.
This is a scholarship.
For 6 months.
Oh.
The reason why we're bringing it to Cebu and not sa ibang cities, because dapat nga, after the end of the training, IT companies, there are a lot of IT companies in Cebu. In fact,
yes.
JP Morgan and the Accenture, they can be hired by them after the training.
Wow. Ibang level.
Ibang level na yan.
Yun.
So, yeah. We hope that, you know, those in the audience right now listening, if hindi man kayo ang mag, you know, ang mag-apply or mag-take advantage dun sa programs that I mentioned, maybe you can share these programs with your friends, with your family and relatives, diba?
Ayun, yeah. And really, ano nga eh, ang dami nag-share po na groups ng ano ng ating broadcast ngayon. So,
yeah.
Hopefully,
yay, thank you.
Hopefully po, hopefully makarating po sa mga ano, sa mga gustong mag-VA, gustong samahan dito sa pagiging digital workers. Hindi na po natin kailangan mag-abroad. You just have to have the skills. So, maraming programs ng DICT, guys. If you, pag medyo hindi pa kayo confident na maging na, sa inyong digital skills, pwede kayo magsimula sa basic digital literacy ng Tech for Ed. Kung medyo confident na kayo pero kailangan ninyo ng digital skills, then we have the Digital Jobs PH, yung dating RIST, Rural Impact Sourcing Technical Training Program.
And then if we develop na.
Yeah.
Vida, ano, and Julia, we have our Facebook page, digital.ph. In fact, if they have questions, pwede silang mag-send ng message doon. If they want to know the other programs, actually, we regularly share, promote yung mga different projects namin in those different programs. So, makikita nila.
Oo.
And if they have more queries, they have more questions, they can just send us. So, digital.ph, Facebook page.
Oo. So, we will include it in the, ano, in the description. And, ano, Ma'am Emmy, thank you po again. Opo,
thank you po.
Related sa training, ano po, guys, next week, magpapahinga lang sandali. Sandali, hindi kami mawawala.
Sandali lang.
Maghahanap buhay lang po kami. Pero the following week, may guest po tayo ulit, ano, we will be talking about social media management. So, mga addict sa Facebook, Instagram, pagkakitaan naman ng addiction nyo, we'll be talking to Jessica Madraso, who is also a digital jobs trainer, by the way. And she'll be talking about
social media management.
Oo. So, anong gagawin nila, Bida, to take to watch us the following?
At para alamin din itong mga kwan, itong mga information na to on how you can get a job online, subscribe to our page, VAD Trip, the VAD Trip Show. Like us, PM us for topic suggestions and guestings. Yung mga gusto maging guest dyan, sagutin nyo naman po yung mga tanong namin. Gusto naman po namin kayo makilala muna para ma-introduce namin kayo ng, ano, ng maigi. So, mag-iwan din kayo ng comments and recommendations on our videos and pages. Makikita po namin yan.
Oh, so mga gusto mag-sponsor sa amin.
Gusto nyo mag-sponsor sa amin?
We're ready to sell out.
Ah, dito po kami.
Ayun. So, thank you guys for watching. Thank you so much, Ma'am Emmy. Napupunta pa sa banyo.
Excited ulit ako for DICT.
Have a great morning, guys.
Okay, thank you. Have a great day, guys.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye.